Good morning, friends. So in this video, we are going to learn the beautiful poem, Trees Are the Kindest Things I Know, written by Harry Penn. This poem is included in the 8th standard state board. So now, from the title, we come to know that trees are the kindest things I know. How can we say so? Trees are the kindest because you know very well, friends, trees give us different types of things, flowers, wood, shade, medicine, many things. Trees are useful, and it is said that trees are our lungs. So in this beautiful poem, we can learn the importance of trees. Okay, and this beautiful poem he has written by Harry Penn especially for all of us. Okay, so now in the very beginning, when we think about the title, then this title once again comes in the very beginning of the poem. Means this title is written once again in the very beginning of the poem. So trees are the kindest things I know. I know means writer know, and each and everyone knows well. Okay. So trees are the kindest things I know. How can we say so? In the very beginning, I ask question to you. How can we say so? Because trees gives us everything. Okay. Tree gives us everything. So which things you I have also told you. But now through this poem, we come to know that this is the kindest. So trees are the kindest things I know. I know very well, trees are the kindest things. They do not harm. Trees are harmless. Trees always help us. So they don't harm to anyone. They simply grow. You know very well, when we plant the trees, then you know very well from the seeds, they brings. And step by step, they simply grow. But they don't harm to anyone. And spread a shade for sleepy cows. And you know very well, friends, then maximum cattles, buffalo, cows, calf, different types of cattles, cows, they always sleep in the shade of trees, silently. Okay. So now they spread a shed for the sleepy cows. Means they give something to the cows, cattle as well as all of us. And gather among their bows. And gather among bows. I think that there is something missed. Birds or something missed. I will see. I will check in the textbook. And gather birds. Right, here we have to write birds. And gather birds among their bows. They give shade to the cows. In the same way, birds always gather among their bows. Bows means branches. Okay, bows means branches of the tree. So on different types of branches, birds always come and they live peacefully. They give, and now we are going to move toward the second stanza. They give us, they means here, this is the pronoun used for the trees. Okay, say, so they give us fruit in leaves of hope. Okay, now they give us fruit. They always give us fruit and wood to make our houses. And you know very well, in today's condition, we live in our houses. So, you know very well, it's a particular window, it's particular door made from the only wood. And this wood we can get only from the trees. So, and food to make our houses of, and leaves to burn on Halloween. Halloween means what? It is the definitely a festival which is celebrated in the Western countries. So, now and leaves to burn, and especially, you know very well in Halloween, this is the festival. So in that particular festival, leaves are necessary for burning. Okay. And in the spring, new buds of green. In the same way, in autumn, there are four seasons in the Western countries. Okay. So autumn means it is the, you know very well what season which is in the Western countries, and in this autumn trees leave falls down. Okay, and you know very well in autumn trees leave fall down. In the same way, and in the spring new buds of green, and especially in the spring is also season, it is the one kind of season. At that moment, new buds of green means new leaves comes again on their branches. So it is too much useful. Trees are the kindest things I know, means each and everyone knows. Kindest means too much kind-hearted, one who is always ready to give everything. Okay, so now we are going to learn once again further lines. They are the first, when days begin to touch the beams of morning sun. So they are the first when days begin. You know very well days begin with the sunrise, and because of the sunrise what happen? The sun rises in the east. In the same way, sun's rays fall in the very beginning, first of all on that particular branches and leaves, to touch the beams of morning sun. You know very well, each and every trees, in the same way, each and every tree's leaves touch the beams of the morning sun. Means our beginning is from just the trees. They are the last to hold the light when evening changes into night. In the same way, our beginning is from the trees. In the same way, our end is also. Means in the evening, evening is also related to our trees. How can we say so? These lines definitely tells us about it. They are the last to hold the light. In the same way, when sun arises in the east and these beams of the rays touches to the leaves. In the same way, when, you know very well, they are the last to hold the light when evening changes into the night. And evening time, when sun goes, at the moment that beams touches once again to the leaves, they are the last to hold the light. And you know very well, the sun's light goes with the sun when evening changes into night. In this way, when evening changes into night, evening means around, we can say, 5 to 7 timing, between 5 to 7 at the moment, evening. Okay, so this evening changes into the night. It happens, it creates something different effects on, definitely on the trees. And when a moon, now last stanza, and when a moon floats on the sky, they hum a drowsy lullaby. And when the moon, you know very well, in the night, at the moment moon floats on the sky, moon definitely floats, means comes in the sky, and it gives light to each and everyone. Especially the moon's light falls once again on the trees in the very beginning, means our beginning is from trees, our last breath is from the trees. They hum a drowsy lullaby at the moment, trees drowsy lullaby, they hum. Okay, at the moment when we sit or go under the trees, then we come to know that the drowsy lullaby we can hear. And of sleepy children long ago, at the moment, you know very well, we are all, our children, students, each and everyone, they are ready to go to the bed for sleeping. At the moment, such type of trees definitely sings a lullaby to all of us, just like our mother sings
for us for the sleeping. Trees are the kindest things I know, and definitely trees, you know very well, we have learned the importance of the trees in this beautiful poem. That's why we can say these are the kindest things, and each and everyone knows, each and every single lines, each and every single words, we come to know that from this line, from this poem, we come to know that. And when we read this poem, we come to know that what it is too much essential for all of us. That's why we should always think, we should never cut the trees, we should always worship the trees, because trees are the kindest things, each and everyone knows well. So thanks for watching this beautiful poem and video. Okay, so now if you like this video, please comment, share and subscribe. Thank you very much.